Good morning. This is the last lecture in the first unit. So I will cover one problem on gyroscopic couple, which I have named as a miscellaneous problem. So actually, why I called this is a miscellaneous problem is the reason behind it. It is not a new problem. It is a simple problem, but it needs your basic fundamental knowledge like moments taking and other concepts applied to the gyroscopic part. That's why it is a separate entity I call as a miscellaneous problem. Okay, so in previous lectures we have seen how to find out the gyroscopic couple magnitude and its direction for four wheeler, two wheeler and everything. Now this is a case of like a four wheeler, but it is moving on a track. So the two wheels are connected to one axle and another two wheels are connected to another axle. So there are two wheels are given and you are supposed to find out what is the load coming on the rise due to the wheels, okay, by mass, centrifugal force as well as the gyroscopic force. And here there is a banking angle is there. That banking angle will considered in the gyroscopic part. Okay, so this is a combination of a four wheeler simple case and a two wheeler angle of heel. Both are combined in a single entity. Let us see what is the problem given here. The total mass of a four wheeled trolley car is 1800 kg. Then the car runs on rails of 1.6 meters, gears and rounds a curve of 24 meters radius. At 36 kmph, the track is banked at 10 degrees. The external diameter of the wheels is 600 mm and each pair, look at here, each pair with the axle has a mass of 180 kg with a radius of gyration of 240 mm. The height of the center of the mass of the car above the wheel base is 950 mm. Determine the pressure on each rail allowing for centrifugal force as well as gyroscopic couple, isn't it? So let me read and repeat once again the problem. There is a railway track like track and the rail is moving on it and there is a banking angle of 10 degrees. Okay, by considering the entire mass of the vehicle as well as the wheels mass, considering the gyroscopic action, centrifugal action, self weight, what is the pressure that is acting on the rails, so I have written here, I have underlined some of the values which I need to solve the problem. So the data given is, I have summarized here, mass 1800 kg, okay, then this is 1.6 meters is the gauge length, that is the distance between inner and outer wheel, then the radius of curvature 24 meters, velocity 36 kmph, convert it into meters per second, how 36 into this is 1000, okay, by 3600, okay, so this you get 10 meters per second. Converting this kilometers into meters, then hour into seconds, then banking angle 10 degrees, then the wheel diameter 0.6 meters, then automatically its radius will be 0.3 meters. Then the mass of the wheel, pair of wheel is 180 kg. Mass of the pair of the wheel is 180 kg. And radius of gyration 0.24 meters and h is equal to 0.95 meters. So with this data, first I will draw my diagram. So this is the skeleton of the diagram. I will apply all the force components and everything here one by one. Okay, see, this is the trolley car where there are four wheels. Okay, two more wheels are there on the rear side. Okay, I am calling wheel A and wheel B. Wheel A and wheel B. This is wheel A and this is the wheel B. Then the center of gravity is somewhere here, and this is a distance of h from the ground. This is my ground surface, and this ground is with the horizontal an angle of theta, an angle of theta. Okay, then this is the h from the ground to the center of gravity. Then the self weight, which acts vertically downwards, this is W, this is capital W, and the width of the track I write with small w. Okay, then you can see there is a centrifugal force FC. Then by the geometry, this becomes theta, then this also becomes theta. This becomes theta and this is also becomes theta. Then you can resolve this force W, which is mg, into two components. One is mg sin theta and another one is mg cos theta. Say this is theta, then a horizontal component which acts towards like this. This is mg this is sin theta. Okay, then what about mg cos theta? So mg cos theta is a vertical component like this. Is mg cos theta. Then coming to the FC, that is the centrifugal force, there are two components once again along this plane and along this plane. So if this is theta, then this becomes FC cos theta. FC cos theta, and this becomes FC sin theta. Okay, so this is the total force analysis. This is the total force analysis, and the reactions are by the ground. Okay, on the wheels, let me call RA, RB, RA, RB. So first draw this diagram. This is very, very important diagram. So the given vehicle, which is making an angle of theta, okay, then the self weight is vertically acting downwards, W, And if this is theta, by the geometry, this becomes theta and this also becomes theta. Then the component of this, a sine component along the ground parallel mg sine theta, and along this direction it is mg cos theta. Then centrifugal force always acts parallel to the ground fc, and its component one is fc sine theta and another one is fc cos theta. Then the reaction coming by the ground on the wheels is ra rb. So the same thing I have shown you here. So I have shown the same thing, fc cos theta, fc sin theta, the same which we have discussed I am showing here, fc cos theta, fc sin theta. Then this is w sin theta, w cos theta, and this is self weight w, and h is height from the center of gravity of the vehicle from the ground, and width of the track is small w. Reaction set a and b are ra rb in the upward direction. Now I will apply simple my first year mechanics which we have learned. So consider the centrifugal force and dead weight, that is the centrifugal force as well as the dead weight. First I consider self weight, dead weight as well as the centrifugal force, okay, to find my ra rb. How we can calculate? We can easily calculate by applying your simple first year basic principles. How I treat it, the sum of the forces in the vertical direction upward is equal to sum of the forces in the downward directions. That is Ra and Rb, Ra and Rb. So Ra and Rb are Ra and Rb are in the upward direction. So I used it Ra plus Rb. So I am resolving the force is perpendicular to the track. So this is the track. Track is like this. So track is like this. So perpendicular to the track, Ra, Rb. So what are the components in this perpendicular direction? Other components, one is w cos theta, and another one is fc sin theta. So w place I write mg, vehicle mass and acceleration due to gravity. Fc place I write centrifugal force mv square by r. So mg mass of the vehicle, g is the acceleration due to gravity, capital M is the mass of the vehicle, v is the velocity, r is the radius of the curvature, theta is the banking angle is already given. So in the problem we are already given mass 1800 kg, g 9.81, theta 10 degrees, okay, velocity initially it was given 36 km/h. I have converted into meters per second by writing 36 into 1000 by 3600, which I got 10. That then capital R, radius of the curvature. By substituting the entire data, I get my value of this Ra plus Rb. Sum of Ra plus Rb is 18,692 newtons. The sum is 18,692 newtons. Okay, this is the first part. Then after considering that, what I would like to do, I will find out the reaction simple Ra and Rb by considering the moments. First, what I have taken, some of the vertical forces perpendicular to the ground, okay, summarized it and summed it, and I got Ra plus Rb value. With that Ra plus Rb value, I have to find out Ra Rb separately. For that, I take moments at any point either A or B. So let me consider the moments at B. I consider the moments at B. If I consider the moments at B, let us see. Ra is causing, what type of couple it is causing? It is giving a moment, clockwise moment. Let me take it as a positive Ra from the B to A. So here that distance is W, that is RAW, isn't it? And what is the another component I have here, a plus one, that clockwise moment FC cos theta. So this FC cos theta multiplied by H, that will be FC cos theta into H. When I write it on the opposite side, that is on the right hand side, it becomes negative. So this is minus FC cos theta into H. Then what forces are left? So we have considered Ra, we have considered FC cos theta, then I have the components MW cos theta, that is MG cos theta, and W sin theta. Okay, these are the two components I have. So this is taking moments from here. Okay, then W cos theta, W is nothing but MG cos theta into W by 2, because it is acting here. So this is W by 2. So W cos theta into W by 2, W is capital MG, small W by 2. Then the other component, FC sin theta into W by 2, both of them are giving an anti-clockwise moment. So I have taken clockwise moment as a positive, then anti-clockwise moment is negative. If I take it on the right hand side of the equation, they becomes positive. Then finally, the last component is W sin theta. So this W sin theta, which is nothing but MG sin theta, is causing an anti-clockwise moment multiplied by the value of H. So this equation, I got it by simply taking the moments. How I have taken moments at B, MB is equal to 0. So to write this, what I did, a simple way, what I did is, this is Ra into W, this is small w. Okay, that is, I have taken that part, a single entity this side, then I am writing all the other things. What is it? The next thing is my MW sin theta, W sin theta, okay, multiplied by H. Then this FC cos theta into H. Then what are the two more components I have? W cos theta into W by 2. And finally, what is one more component? FC sin theta. FC sin theta into small w by 2. So So where there is capital W, I have replaced by capital Mg. Where there is a centrifugal force, there I have placed Mv square by R. Okay, then by substituting that and given data, when I substitute the mass 1800 g9.81, okay, V10, the entire data is substituted with the given data which is available with me. With that, by solving, I get the value of RA is 11,911 newtons. So the first part is 9346 minus the second part 2565 is So first I get this, by solving this I get RA. So I get, by solving this equation RA, I get this RA is 6781 newton. By substituting the entire data, I get first the value of RA. So I have already with me RA plus RB is equal to, I have with me the value of RA plus RB is 18,682. Okay, this is RA plus RB. Then RB is equal to 18,682 minus 6781, where I get the value of RP, that is 11,911 newtons. So I got the values of RA comma RP. These values is already obtained. So after obtaining these RA RP values, what I will do? So I would like to apply my gyroscopic couple. Okay, as I said here, it is a combination of your four-wheeler and two-wheeler banking, because here the wheel is making an angle theta. So I omega p will be converted as I omega p cos theta. Why? Because it's not horizontal, the spin axis is not horizontal. The spin axis is like this direction, and this is theta. So the previous two-wheeler analysis, we have seen same case it is happening. So the cos component is to be considered. This becomes a cos component. So I omega p cos theta. So total how many axles we have? Two axles. And he has given each axle IW and omega W, of course, omega p. So that gives 2IW omega W cos theta omega p. We know IW is mk square, and V by W is V by small r. Then omega P V by capital R, then it becomes V square by RR into cos theta. So substitute everything, that is 180 is the M value, then K value 0.24, radius of gyration, velocity 10 meters per second, small r, radius of the wheel 0.3 meters, radius of curvature 24, banking angle is 10 degrees. By substituting everything, I get my CW that is reaction due to the gyroscopic action, okay, due to wheels is 283.6 Newton meter. So after getting this magnitude, I have to find out the reaction. So it is as good as like in a four wheeler, okay, after getting the couple by dividing by 2 into the width of the track. So CW, just now we calculated 283.6, then width of the track is 1.6, then RGO, okay, this we called in the automobile problem like P/2, same. The only thing here I have used the terminology like RGO and RGI, it gives 88.6 Newtons. So this is same applicable to your four wheeler. This magnitude is upward on the outer wheels and it is downward on the inner wheels. Upward on the outer wheels and downward on the inner wheels. This is RG. Then finally, what is the pressure on the rails? He has given pressure on the rails. Okay. So the pressure on the rails is on outer rails and inner rails. This is outer rail and this is inner rail. Inner rail. See here, this is RB on outer rail upward due to self weight. And due to the gyroscopic is also upward. Okay. So the reaction is upward, but whereas in the pressure on the rails is in the downward. Because till now what we are talking is the reaction by the ground on the wheel. But what is asking the problem? Pressure on rails. The pressure, that is reaction by the wheel on the ground, not ground on the wheel. That is by the wheel on the ground. So you get here positive means the pressure is in the opposite downward. Similar here, RA, the reaction by the ground upward and the gyroscopic is in the downward. So simply I write the above values because RA, RB values already previously I have calculated by substituting that RA and RG values. Okay, I get this is 6692, okay, Newtons, isn't it, which is actually upward because the pressure is in the opposite direction of reaction. Here, when we have seen in the four-wheeler, the inner wheels, the reaction on the ground is downward, then the pressure is in the opposite, that is in the upward. Okay, so this is the way this problem can be solved. This way, this problem can be solved. So I am showing you one more problem, a similar lines with the data difference, with the data difference, same problem, but only the thing is I have changed some data instead of the previous data. Here mass is not given, weight is given. Here weight is given, okay, and gauge length is given 30 meters radius of curvature and speed is 40 km/h and slope I kept the same 10 degrees. Then the axle weighs, each pair of axle weighs 2000 and the external diameter 0.6 meters and the radius of gyration 0.25 meters and the CG is h is equal to 1 meter. So the same problem, the previous problem which I have solved, I changed only the data part. Otherwise, the previous problem and this problem, same, only the numbers has been changed. So I am not explaining this, the data given, everything like the previous. The solution is complete solution is given in your PPT. You can go for this. So I hope this part you will do your own instead of copying this. But the solution is available if you want. But I recommend you to do yourself without referring this solution. The entire solution is given. Finally, the reactions on the inner rail and the reactions on the outer rail. Okay, this you can cross check by solving. Okay, so the previous problem which I have explained is same with only the numbers change. Okay, so with this we finish the first unit. Thank you.